Given the following three sentences can be revised into one better sentence. Choose a sentence that is the best version. Okay, if you observe the given sentence, it has three parts. First part, second part, third part. So these three parts should be replaced with one of these four, which can be the best one. Right? So pick up one. I hope you did. Now let us check what is correct. Given I was at the fair, I got lost, I got scared. If you observe, all the three parts of the sentence is actually in terms of past. Now, so the converted or the better version must also be in the past. You tell me what are the options that I can eliminate. Now, whenever you use am, I am reading, I am going, we cannot say I am read, etc., etc. So am is used for the present tense. Am is a term which is used for the present tense, but not past. So I can eliminate two options. Option A is eliminated, option C is eliminated. Now, in between B and C, we have to choose one, the best version. Right? Now, just read the sentence of B. I went to the fair and I got scared as I was lost. Fine. I went to the fair and got scared. Why? Because I was lost. Yeah. Now, reading 4, option D, I got lost at the fair and was scared. Yes, this is also meaningful. Both are meaningful. But which is the best one we have to pick? If you observe, in the given sentences, the three sentences, it was never mentioned that the boy or I was going to the fair. They just said I was at the fair, right? So I cannot take I went to the fair as an extra statement or extra info. So this becomes an extra information, right? Which is not required. So I can say I got lost at the fair. Being at the fair, you got lost and then you are scared. So that gives me a perfect answer for the question. So option D is the best version of the three given sentences. So in this question, we have to fill these blanks. Two blanks we have, so we have to fill these two. Let me directly go with the statements. In this particular question, the paragraph or the passage is talking about Henry. Now here, the question starts. Henry is an dash. For example, I like to tell you one strategy. Whenever we have a and an, just observe. And when we use an, what is the next term that we can use? With a vowel sounded only. An can be used before a vowel sounded. A is used before a consonant sound. So let us check the options whether all are vowel sounded or not. A, astronaut, astrologist, astronomer, astronaut. So all are starting with a sound. So which is a vowel sound. So I cannot eliminate any option. If you have any option called pilot, for example, let me check. Now pilot, it is not a vowel sound. It's a consonant sound. So I can eliminate the options. So I'm telling you the strategy. Okay. So just remember this. Full stop. He looks at the sky and stars in particular. Okay. Given he looks particularly towards what? Sky and stars. So using this, we can answer what kind of person Henry is. So Henry is a dash astrologer. Now you tell me what astrologer basically does. If you don't know, I like to tell you. Astrologer is someone who gives or predicts horoscopes. You know horoscopes, right? So what happens in your today's life, etc., etc. So, and he gives information on the horoscopes that are personalized by birth date. So this is basically, I can say predictions. Astrologer is someone who can predict something, who predicts. But is this anyway related to the person who observes sky and stars in particular? No. Now, talking about the astrologist, who is an astrologist? Astrologist is a person who uses astrology, right? Who uses astrology. Basically, it is related to the previous one. Right? Can I take this option called B? No, because the one who uses astrology is called as an astrologist. But Henry is not an astrologist. Why? Because he basically don't predict the predictions. Coming to option C, astronomer. Who is an astronomer? Astronomer is actually a scientist in the field of astronomy who focus their studies on specific questions or fields outside scope of Earth. That means they observe astronomical objects like stars, planets, moons, comets, etc. I hope you understood the point. So astronomy is simple terms. In simple terms, we can say astronomy is a person who observes Earth, planet, stars, sun, etc., etc. So can I take this as an option? Yes, I can consider. Why? Because he looks particularly towards sky and stars. So where are Earth, planets, and all the other things are in sky itself. So I can consider astronomer. Now let us take astronaut also. Because we can get to know meanings of different terms, right? Now, who is an astronaut? Astronaut is a person who is well trained to travel in spacecraft. Now, is Henry traveling in spacecraft anywhere over the passage? No, not anywhere. So I would say option C must be the perfect fit in the blank. So Henry is an astronomer. Now, so with C, we have two options, option B and option D. So I can eliminate A and C as of now. Now, coming to the next. His last thing about his job is looking through the telescope, and today he's very excited. Okay, now, so he's looking excited, looking at the beginning of a new star. That I can say. Now, the given thing is, his last thing, what kind of thing can I say is favoring thing? Look, do we have any term called favoring thing? No, we say favorite thing, right? So favoring is not a correct term that you can use here. Now, pleasant thing. Now, we feel pleasant. We feel pleasant and we seem pleasant, but it is not like it's a pleasant thing, right? His pleasant thing about his job. No, I cannot say pleasant. Now, pleasing, not again. His pleasing thing about the job. No, but I can say his favorite. Yes, his favorite thing about his job is looking through the telescope. Look, we already seen Henry always looks carefully into the telescope. So that means it should be his favorite hobby kind of thing. So his favorite hobby or his favorite thing. We basically say whenever we talk about our hobbies, we basically it's my favorite hobby. We don't say it's my pleasing or pleasant hobby. Correct? So D for the second blank. So which says C in the first blank, D in the second blank. Option B must be my correct answer. Let us answer this question now. We have to find an error in the sentence. If no error, we have to pick up no error option. Let us check the sentence. Every day, life has become more complicated with the advancement in mobile technology. Is there any error? Yes. If you observe everyday life, life is what actually? Life is a singular term. Right? Whereas lives is a plural term. Correct? Life is a singular, whereas lives is a plural term. So for life, which is a singular, what verb we should use? We should use a singular verb. Why? Because subject verb agreement. What is a subject verb agreement? When the subject is singular, the verb should also be singular. And when the subject is plural, the verb should also be plural. So here, as life is a singular term, the verb should also be singular. But what is have? They have, we have. Where we have is a plural verb, instead of have, it should be has. Right? So there is an error in which part? In the part of A. Why? Because every day, life has become should be the answer instead of have. So option A is the answer. Let us check out this question. A sentence has been given in either active voice or passive voice. Out of the four alternatives suggested, here we have A, B, C, D. Select the one which best expresses the same sentence in passive or active voice. That means if the given sentence is active, we have to convert and express it in passive. And if given sentence is in passive, we have to convert it into the active voice. I hope you understood the point. Now, so firstly, we have to identify what voice it is, whether it is active voice or passive voice. Now tell me, when can something be an active voice or when can something be called as a passive voice? If you don't know, just listen to me. For example, if I say Ravi eats bananas. Now tell me, Ravi is doing what? Ravi is eating what? Bananas. Now always remember, we have three parts in a sentence: subject, verb, object. So here, what is happening? The subject is performing the action. Subject is performing the action. So I can say this is an active voice for sure. So always remember, whenever the subject performs the action, it is nothing but the active voice. Right? Now, when can it be passive voice? Now, if you want to convert this in the other tense, then can you tell me what exactly happens? Now, bananas are eaten by Ravi. Correct or not? Now, here what is happening? Look, I have said the same, but in the other voice. Now here, bananas is the subject I have, eaten is the verb I have, and object is nothing but Ravi. Correct? Now here, bananas is the subject. Look, always the first part in a sentence is nothing but the subject. So here, bananas is the subject. So what is happened to the banana? Bananas are eaten by. So subject is receiving an action if you observe over here. Subject is receiving the action or an action, the action. So whenever subject receives the action, it is called as a passive voice. I hope everybody understood the difference between active voice and passive voice. So whenever subject performs the action, it is called as active, and whenever the subject receives, it becomes the passive voice. Now if you observe the given question, call in the next candidate. Look here, do you have the perfect subject? No, I don't have any particular subject. So let it be dummy subject. So someone is telling that call in the next candidate. So they are performing the action called calling someone as an ex-candidate, correct? So I can say this is an active voice if I'm not wrong. Correct, people? Now, all this must be in passive voice, correct? If you observe, is B is in the passive voice? No, it is the same. So I can eliminate option B, right? Now, if you observe, there are three options which are in the passive voice. What are they? Let the next candidate be called. Let the next candidate called. Let the next candidate be called. You tell me what is perfect over here. Again, the object must come to the subject's place. And as there is no subject, I'm just making it reverse. That's it. So you tell me all the sentences are starting with let. Now, everybody, whenever you use let, along with the let word, there is one more word that is used for sure. Mostly, I can say 99% of times. Exactly. It is nothing but be. Let it be. Let the cup be there. Let the cup be lifted. Let the number be X, the most frequently used sentence, right? Exactly. So definitely, guys, I need a be form with the word called let. And moreover, when you are converting active into passive voice, there should be a be form for sure for such sentences. So let the next candidate be called is my correct answer. I cannot say let the next candidate be called. And definitely, we must use V3 form of verb in the passive voice. If you observe, active voice eats became eaten. So similarly, active voice call must be the called. Why? Because called is the V3 form of call. So let us check the last question in the video. So here we have a anchored parajumble or a fixed parajumble where the first or the last or the first and the last will be fixed. So we have first and the last as fixed and we have to arrange in between the four statements. Right? Let us look at the first statement given. Above 2 in 5 currently married women have experienced. Fine, have experienced what? Have experienced, let us read P. Spousal violence in their current marriage. Yes, it can be possible. Why? Because they are talking about married women and having an experience of spousal violence. Spousal violence means what? So here, spousal violence means what? Spouse refers to their husbands, right? Their partners. As they are talking about women, the partner should be men. So the men making violence against the woman. So that is what spousal violence is in their current marriage life. So I can keep this P on a hold, right? Now, can I say, have experienced women who report both physical and sexual? No, I cannot say that. Women have experienced women who report. It is not making sense. So Q cannot be at the start. Now again, have experienced violence are more likely to have injuries. Yes, I can say women have experienced violence are more likely to have injuries. Yes, I can say this also. But it is not very clear what violence they are going to. Why? Because we have some violences that are mentioned over here. Spousal, physical and sexual. So it is not directly mentioned what violence it is. So I'm not just keeping it on hold. Now, next, the last one. Women have experience and be subject to. No, not making sense. So it cannot be Q first of all. And it may be R and we can have P mostly. Why? Because it is very clearly saying that women have experienced spousal violence in their current marriage. And so and continuation what? And women who report both physical and sexual. Sexual what? Again, violence. Now here we have a link. So this violence is nothing but the sexual violence. Right? So Q and R is a pair. And similarly, P and Q is a pair, if you observe. Why? Because it is a continuation. Current marriage and women who report both physical and sexual violence are more likely to have injuries and be the subject to more severe forms of physical violence than women who report. So I hope you understood the point. So Q comes first and then S comes and then 6 comes. So it is directly a PQRS order, which is nothing but PQRS. Option D is my answer. I hope everybody understood the point. So guys, I hope you like the methods that we use to answer the questions, right? So thank you for watching the video till the end. If you have liked the video, do not forget to press the like button. Also join our social media handles like Telegram group, Instagram page, and WhatsApp group. Links to all these handles are given in the description below. Thank you so much.